again. Big disgrace, waving your banner all over the place.
We will rock you.
Sing it!
We will rock you.
Buddy, you're an old man, poor man, pleading with your eyes, gonna make you zombie someday. You got mud on your face. Big disgrace, somebody better put your bag into your place.
Oh! tint. But another one bites the dust. Bites the dust.
stick to Mr. Strittmatter's head.
All given us really helps out just here on the field. We appreciate it all. I'd like to wish the cross country team good luck to the stage, good luck to the volleyball team. We really appreciate everybody's support. Brian said he'd like to thank you for all the support you've given us and come out to the game stuff. Unless you're a player, you really don't know how much that means, because every time, especially Beatrice, I know we've only had 2 home games so far, but especially against Beatrice, every time we do something right, you hear this big cheer, and every time they do something right, you don't hear anything. You don't realize how much difference that makes in a tight game, especially like that one was for a while anyway. It really makes a difference, and it really helps us to come out and support us in the large numbers we've had this year, and we hope to give you a good show tonight, so just keep on coming out, and we hope to please you.
I would just like to say, first of all, I thank all of you coming out, and again, just like everybody else supporting us, but I would like to congratulate the cross-country team and Coach Brady for the performance that they had yesterday. The boys qualified for the state. I would, before I go on with my annual thing, I would like my non-starter, everybody who's a non-starter, line up here, please. You know, you always know who's starting. The reason that you can hear it, and their name gets announced and all that. We have approximately 38 other kids, 35 right in that range, that makes us a good football team. Every week, these guys have to go up and they have to scrimmage our varsity, our first team. And if they do a good job, then that makes us better. These people don't get a lot of recognition except from their teammates, the seniors, the juniors, the sophomores who isn't starting. But the coaches and stuff, we know that if we're going to be a successful team so far, these guys have made us that way. So let's have a round for the applause, a round of applause for the people who get recognized. Their last football game. Tonight is a game they'll remember. It's a game we want to remember. We got in a position now. Maybe we're going to have a lot more memories than just homecoming.
Yeah!
Are you ready?
Yeah!
Let's go on the first one. I mean, ready? Yep.
We want to win, and we're going to win with class. And we're going to win tonight. Come out and help us.
Well, just out of school, like a I paid my dues time after time. I've done my sentence, but committed no crime. And bad mistakes, I've made a few.
I'm just the one to say whether we punt on fourth down or whether we go for it, but we have a lot of team unity in the coaches too.
Coach, congratulations on a winning season. We've got a bunch of seniors out here we'd like to talk to you right now. Thanks.
Oh, I haven't really hit yet. I'm sure tomorrow morning when I wake up, it's really going to hit me. I don't know. We decided this year, our seniors and everybody got together, and we decided to take one game at a time. We set goals, and a lot of our goals were to get in the playoffs, and a lot of us were, we wanted to win 6, 7, 8 games, and we decided to just take one game at a time. And as the season was going, we saw, you know, we just kept winning and kept winning, kept playing as a team, and everything's just come together now at hand.
Chad, we're a junior senior dominated type team this year. Obviously, we've got great leadership out of the senior class this year. Is there any rivalry between the senior class and the junior class? Do you guys get along pretty good?
Oh yeah, there's no rival at all. We're really good friends. There are all these guys out here, like my best friends, and there's no rival. everybody here works as a team, and these guys are all, I just love them all.
Senior season with an undefeated regular season.
Feels great. I don't think I'm gonna really realize how great it is until tomorrow morning when I wake up.
Tony, this is something you'll be able to carry with you for the rest of your life, an undefeated regular season. What does it look like for the playoffs for the Bulldogs?
It looks pretty good, I think. I think we just keep our same game plan one at a time, play as a team, stay out there, you know, just go at it. I think we should do pretty good.
We probably should ask Coach Strittmatter this. What's the practice schedule up until next Wednesday? Are you going to hit it hard tomorrow and the weekend, or what are you guys going to do?
Yeah, we got practice on the weekend. We get tomorrow off, but I think it won't be too tough.
Tony, congratulations on a great season for
Thanks
you.
Thanks a lot.
Words are our best hit of the year, our best hit of the week awards for you this year?
Oh, just against the Nebraska City game, which was pretty fun. It was a lot of fun. But I think everybody just gets pumped up and gets going on defense. And I don't think there's one single person that's a defensive player. I think it's the whole team.
Brian, any preference on who you'd like to play in the playoffs?
Well, my brother-in-law coaches for Cathedral, and he told me that Blair called him for the Nebraska City film. So I don't know.
Anybody scare you in the playoffs, or you think we can handle anybody?
Oh, if we play together as a team, I think we can handle just about anybody. But we just got to stick together and play as a team and keep together.
Thank you, Brian.
I believe it. And even today when we were watching that highlight film, we just all got emotional about it because we realized all the good things that happened throughout the season and all the work we put in, it all come together. And you watch the highlight film and all your efforts throughout the year just came together in that film, and it makes you it just psychs you up for every game after that to add to that.
Brad, any special satisfaction having your dad as a football coach and seeing him have an undefeated season?
Yeah, it was, because I've been to quite a few football games, you know, since I was young, and I've seen some real good teams, and I've seen some teams that weren't so good, and it's real nice to get that 9-0 season. I remember when he was 8-1 and 7-2, but get 9-0 was really good.
Will this make him easier to live with this winter, do you think?
Maybe.
Brad Strittmatter, congratulations on a great senior season.
Thanks.
Okay. What do you weigh this year?
45 if I'm lucky.
Sometimes we noted that you're going up against kids giving up maybe 100 pounds. The tackle that you play across from your guard position in the offensive line, that's really tough for us to imagine. What do you use special technique-wise to handle those big kids?
Well, Coach Oliver, he said he was a small lineman like me, and he said just go after him. If you keep going after him, you're going to get him.
Like offense or defense better, Chris?
I like them both. I used to hate offense, but now, you know, when you got running backs like Quentin, Tony, and Chad, they run the ball so good. I mean, you like blocking for them.
What's your thoughts on going into the playoffs? Anybody in particular you'd like to play, or just whomever we draw?
Whoever we draw.
Okay, good luck in the playoffs, Chris.
Thanks.
A lot of us have been out here working hard for 4 years, and there's no doubt about it. Every one of us has wanted to quit sometime or another, but we've all held on and came through.
What's the biggest factor that made you guys undefeated? Do you think it was talent, or do you think it was hard work?
Hard work and a good team effort, I think.
What do you think of your senior class teammates finishing undefeated like that? When you guys were in middle school, junior high, playing football, what were your expectations back then? Did you set any goals for yourself?
We always talked about it. We knew we were going to be a good team, but we had no idea that this was coming.
Okay. As we mentioned before, we've got kind of a senior, junior-dominated type team. Junior class and the senior class get along pretty good together?
Yeah, real well.
Seems to be a lot of spirit on this team, Terry. Good luck in the playoffs next week.
Thank you.
Your senior season, regular season, undefeated. What's it feel like?
I remember at the beginning of the season, Terry Fulton and I were riding around in my car, and we were just laughing and saying it would be so great to do it, and it's finally here. It just seems like a dream.
What's your thoughts on the playoffs next week? What do you think?
I think if we play good and like we can, then I don't think there's anybody that can beat us.
Biggest thing that seems that affects this ball club, it seems like when we get a lot of intensity and a lot of emotion, that's when we play good. You think we're going to have any trouble getting up for the playoffs, Matt?
Oh, no. No way.
We're going to be ready to go?
Oh, yeah.
Good.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you very much for the interview. How's it feel to finish out your senior season undefeated, Andy?
It's a childhood dream. It's just, it's like nothing you've ever felt in your life. It's great.
Okay. I was going to ask, good or bad?
Great.
Okay, good. You played center for us this year. Done a great job center, played a lot of defense for us, particularly tonight. What do you feel makes the senior class a special group of ball players?
We just all play together as a team and hang in there. And when we get down and everything, we just come together and pull out the wins.
Andy, congratulations on a great senior season. Any thoughts on the playoffs that are going to start next week? Bring them on?
Let's go.
Any particular team you'd like to play?
No.
Okay. Enjoy your day off tomorrow. Have a good week of practice, and good luck in the playoffs next week.
Thank you.
Thanks, Andy. Going about 10 or 15 feet right here. Greg Meyer, senior season, offensive guard. How's it feel to finish your senior season undefeated?
It's unbelievable. I never thought this could happen. That first day we went out to practice, I can't say what it feels like. It's great.
It's pretty exciting, isn't it?
It's great.
We open up the playoffs next Wednesday, Greg. Any thoughts on the playoffs? Anybody you'd like to see us play?
I don't know. I just want to take it all now.
Yeah.
It's just great.
A lot of these kids out here, these seniors, are really emotional. It's the last regular season game. Fortunately, we've got one more game to go. Greg, good luck next week in the playoffs. Good to see you go out to football this year. I believe this is your first year of playing football. Played defensive back, got in on offense tonight. How do you like football?
I really like it because I like hitting people. I like to get a chance to hit people without getting any fouls called on me or anything like that.
Yeah, you don't have to raise your hand and count your fouls in football, do you? What's it feel like to come out for football for your senior season, participate in an undefeated season like this, your senior year? Give me your thoughts right now, please.
It's just great. I haven't lost a football game yet, and I really don't plan on losing one.
That's great. Good luck. Any thoughts on the playoffs next week?
I want a W. That's
okay,
all.
Good. Thank
give me a
Sean
W.
Gibbers, kind of unsung heroes and all that. We talked about you and talked about the intensity that you play out there on the field. What do you weigh now?
About 140.
A couple weeks ago, the guys out here are saying that's an exaggeration, maybe at 140 pounds. We talked a little bit about you're kind of a self-described toughest defensive end in the state of Nebraska. True or false?
Well, if you look at the state of Nebraska for Class B schools, you don't see any more 140-pound defensive ends. So
right.
I could either say I'm the best 140-pounder or the worst 140-pounder. So.
Hey, we've commented up in the booth a number of times. You don't back down from anybody, and we've got a lot of kids out here that are not overly blessed with huge bodies, and you're just kind of exemplify this ball club. What's your thoughts on finishing out your senior season undefeated and going into the playoffs next week?
It's just, well, I'm not going to say it's a dream like everybody else, but it's an awesome reality, and I'm looking forward to it.
How are we going to do next week? Any predictions?
We're going to kill them.
Aaron Shelton, we can go to the bank on that one. Thank you, Aaron.
Ice cream sundae, banana split. We make the orange. today I live, I want to be a day to give the best of me. I'm only one, but not alone. My finest day is yet unknown. I broke my heart for every gain to taste the sweet. I faced the pain. I rise and fall, yet through it all, this much remains.
curtain calls. You brought me fame and fortune and everything that goes with it. I thank you all. But it's been no bed of roses, no pleasure cruise. I consider it a challenge before the whole human race.
Here at Auburn. He started at tight end and defensive end. He's done a great job for us, and a lot of people will not run, they'll run away from him. He's been a great guy for 3 years. Matt Unruh. Matt played tight end and defensive end for us this year, and Matt has worked very hard to become a very good football player. He's been a nice guy to coach. Chris has been a 3-year starter for us at offensive guard and this year at defensive back. Chris only weighs 145 pounds, but he's done a superb job in all the years we've had him. Very tough, 145-pounder. Greg came out his freshman, sophomore years and then set out his junior year and come back the senior year. Greg is he's one of our team players, and he'd do anything for us to be a better team. And that's what he's done this year. He's worked awful hard for us. Brian Moody is another one that's a 3-year starter at offensive tackle and defensive tackle. Brian has done a great job. He has been one of our best one-on-one blockers offensively and defensively. He's been one of our best defensive ball players. Great attitude. Aaron Shelton has been a 2-year starter at defensive end for us, weighs 140 pounds. Like I said, he's probably the toughest 140-pounder in the state in Class B. He's very quick and does a superb job at a defensive end. Will never give up. Tony Grafton started at fullback for us here and linebacker. He was one of our leaders on the team, like a lot of our seniors. Tony, I think, will probably go on and play some college football, and he has done a good job for us. We gave him the ball a little bit more towards the end, and he had a 100-yard game. Very good player. Chad Searcy started at wing back and defensive back for us. Chad's another one who weighs 145 pounds. Very good job one-on-one coverage in the secondary and one of our hardest hitters, pound for pound. He will really get after you. Terry Fulton started a defensive back and split in, and then he blocked some in there double tight as a tight end. Terry's another 140-pounder, and Terry come on this year and really did a superb job in the defensive backfield. He will hit you like the rest of the defensive backfield. Did a good job for us. Sean Gibbs, first-year player coming out for football for us. Chad Searcy's injury, he filled in and started the Beatrice playoff game and did a superb job. if Sean would have been a very good football player if he could have come out for 4 years. He likes to hit, and he's got pretty good speed. He did a good job for us in 1 year. Andy Tynan started at center for us, and when we started the year, we were very worried about the people up the middle, our center and quarterback, and both of them did a superb job. Andy stayed in there, and he went against some pretty tough people, but he never gave up, and he's one of those players that led us on and off the field. Did a real good job for us at center this year. Like I've said before, my coaching staff, my assistants are probably the best in the state. They work hard. We spend a lot of hours, and we try to have some fun, too. And sometimes it's awful hard working with me, but they did a great job, and I appreciate all the hard work they do. They're an excellent coaching staff.